you know.
So, okay, before we transition into like the Up and Smoke tour, because that came shortly after,
yeah,
that song. Mm-hmm. So, well, let's just jump into the Up and Smoke tour. So the Up and Smoke tour. You the only female feature. That was like a legendary tour for those of y'all who don't know, the Up and Smoke tour. So who was off on this tour?
They can't even see my part without paying for it on YouTube. So it's got to be important to this day.
Oh, yeah. I know that's right. See, we're going to get into that. Let's talk about her business now. Well, y'all be trying to play the OGs and hip-hop not knowing that, hey, y'all be trying to say I'm Lil' Kimba, bitch. I own my shit. Own. And we're going to get into that.
They don't want to talk about the owners. We know what happens to owners. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. They don't really give them credit, or they discredit owners. You know what I'm saying? And not to say that people aren't out there doing what they got to do to try to keep their masters. But one thing about me is I can't be in the control inside of that. We're not doing it. And I'm going to still be doing music. So that's why, you know, you can't stop somebody who already doing something.
Right. So, the Up and Smoke tour. I want to know a little bit of behind the scenes about that, because that's a legendary tour. I just want to know, like, how much weed was getting smoked in this dang tour. Let's just get down to the
tour. That is what I can tell you. A lot of weed was getting smoked. It was so many trash bags of weed that was being sold to different artists.
That's what I envisioned.
Snoop said, no more, that I ain't selling y'all no more weed. But, you know, your girl, Miss Toy, is always connected. So I brought another source to the source, and that source followed us. And shout out to, all my New York folks, they know what it is. You know what I mean?
So,
you know, Hakeem came through, and he made sure he blessed us at times when Snoop wasn't giving us none. We still was smoking big on the Up and Smoke, you know?
So for those of you, for the audience who may not know about this tour, can we get, like, who was all featured on this tour, and, like, what was the outcome of this Up and Smoke tour?
You had the intro of the tour was the Eastsiders. Then you have, you know, Ice Cube with the West Side Connection featuring, you know, the You Could Do It song. Then he had MC Ren on his. And it was the 10-year anniversary from N.W.A. So it was huge because they had a big single, and it was in a movie for Next Friday as well. And then you had Eminem, and then you had the big, you know, outro was the Dr. Dre and Snoop Dogg, and it had Exhibit and all of the, you know, Corrupt and everybody who ever did any music on the Chronic or any of the West Coast music, and the whole show just flowed. Every city, every state, we was out there for maybe a few months. And I'm just saying, the night that they started filming the Up and Smoke, building up to the actual footage of it, was just incredible, because everybody came out and showed out. No drama, nobody mm-hmm. killing nobody. The only drama was Detroit didn't want Dr. Dre to play his intro because it was too violent. And you thinking about how this world is so violent, and they have the nerve to try to stop somebody from, you know, you pay for a ticket to see a show. You can't go stop the people's show in the middle of the thing just because y'all feel like it's too much violence. It's so much violence in so many people's songs, and that this was the most successful tour, non-violence, on the West Coast. That's why it's classic, and that's why it's history. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's like kind of unheard of, especially nowadays. Somebody gonna get shot in the foot or something.
That's what they thought.
They thought that, but y'all really like
put it down.
Showed out, and we're like, okay, we're gonna show y'all that we can do this the right way without that stigma attached to, you know, hip hop.
It was sponsored by Hennessy. Look, it was sponsored by Hennessy.
Oh my God, I couldn't even know that. So
everybody was where they were supposed to be.
Oh my God, okay. So you said the tour lasted for like a couple of months.
Yeah.
Like, was it like, how many city tour was it?
Girl, that's 2001. I told you I smoke a lot of weed. I smoke a lot of weed. It was a lot, because I had a big ass suitcase with me. I remember changing every day, because it was like, they had this thing, you know what I mean? Of course, Versus West Side Connection, Matt got the red rag, you know, Dub C got the blue rag, but Cube had the black. So my goal was every city that we went to, I went to go match that middle one. You feel me? To stay in that middle lane with Cube. So every night, you know what I'm saying? That's how I ended up with my black rag and my, you know, my little Daisy Duke white shorts on the Up in Smoke. Cause I was really just like styling the shit out of myself just to fit this criteria of being the West Coast female that's with them. You know what I'm saying? So I'm shout out to myself, you know what I'm saying? Keeping myself.
Oh man,
they're on a tour with all these fucking niggas, and I couldn't bring nobody. I couldn't have a manager with me, stylist with me, or anything. So yeah, shout out to God for protecting me and me being able to go on a tour with everybody from the West Coast. And some of these niggas got cases right now. You know what I'm saying? So I made it through without having no problems, and also being able to move forward in my deal. I actually signed my record deal while I was on the Up in Smoke. So niggas was looking at me like, what the hell is the white dude meeting you at Trump Towers for? Because we stayed at Trump Towers, okay? We did. And he came and brought me my stickers so that I can have some promotion before I leave the tour. You know, we multitasking out here. I'm on Universal and we in New York. So absolutely, I'm getting ready to have a meeting with the people that I'm getting ready to do business with. You know what I'm saying? And they brought me my stickers, and on the back of them, it had that I was currently on the Up in Smoke tour. So boom, you know what I'm saying?
Bam.
We got to take care of business. So then that's when NC Ren was like, what you doing? I'm like, I'm writing to my new record. You know what I'm saying? I'm writing all my new songs. You want to be on my album? And he was like, hell yeah. So I had ended up getting NC Ren on my record. From the Up in Smoke tour, I ran into E-40 after I got off the Up in Smoke, and he ended up being on my record, you know, doing business.
Mm-hmm.
And they ended up doing some music for me on my record during that time. So, yeah, shout out to E-40, Squeak Rule, MC Ren, you know what I mean? Everybody that showed up and showed out for me for my first record.
That's awesome. See, can't nobody say that they accomplished that? And it's just like, Miss Toy Cam, but then you get mistaken for a little Cam, and it was just like, no, right. We're not doing that anymore. You know, okay?